The Steam Deck is a really cool device. Much like when Proton originally launched and people learned that Linux gaming was now actually possible, now it's shown people once again that Linux is a capable system. The only difference is the list isn't 7 or 9 games long like it was back when Proton was first announced. Now, 16,000 games are marked verified or playable by Valve directly, and if you include community reviews of at least one, 22,000 games are playable. And don't get me wrong, there are still issues with some games out there, especially those involving anti-cheat in the top 10 list, which for some reason still don't go and enable the Linux support when they're using a system that is supported by Linux. I don't understand why they don't do this. Whatever. And of course there are issues with mistakes being made along the way where a game is marked as playable, but it's actually supposed to be verified, or a game is marked as verified, but has some serious game-breaking issues that make it so it's just not going to function on this thing, let alone on desktop Linux or Chrome OS and things like that. What I think is a lot more important is how that information is presented to the user. So if they see a game as verified, playable, unsupported, how the information is portrayed to them to make sure that when there are mistakes, they aren't misled into thinking that something is in a worse state or a better state than it actually is. And when those mistakes are discovered, not just by Valve, but by the community, how that is handled to make sure that information gets updated in as quick of a state as is possible. Being marked as verified or playable when it's actually in a worse state, I don't think is as bad as a game that is supposed to be playable or verified being marked as unsupported. In those cases, that can lead to a loss of sale that the developer just didn't have any control over. Before we can talk about how to better handle this system, we need to understand how the system actually works, how a game is supposed to end up in certain categories. This is done with the Steam Deck compatibility review process, all of which is publicly available in their documentation. So verified, your game passes all compatibility checks, no configuration work is required for users to access all game functionality. Playable is your game functions on deck, but may require manual user intervention. So the criteria being used is all of this: controller support, correct controller glyphs, text input, resolution support for what the Steam Deck natively runs at, default configuration that is playable on the Steam Deck, text legibility on the screen of the Steam Deck, no device compatibility warnings, and if you have a launcher, it's recommended that you don't have a launcher. The launcher needs to be controller driven. If your game meets all of this criteria, works exactly like it should on the Steam Deck, no Steam Deck specific bugs, that game is going to be marked as verified. If any of this criteria is not met, for example, you have an old game like the old East games, which have a launcher, but the launcher is keyboard and mouse driven, that game can still be marked as playable, but it won't be verified until that issue is fixed. Now, unsupported is the bottom tier. If your game's Steam Deck compatibility review turns up blocking bugs or performance problems specific to Proton, those issues will be added to our internal issue tracking system and your game will appear with an unsupported badge. Once the issue has been resolved, we'll automatically notify you and retest your game. Stated in another way, unsupported means the game is currently not functional on the Steam Deck. Recently, this post made it past my Twitter feed. Yeah, it runs on stovetop timers, GitHub commit history boxes, pure CSS, and pregnancy tests. Honestly, I believe half of those things, but you have to draw the line somewhere. Steam Deck compatibility, unsupported. Now, this is a special case where it did make sense because it was running on the old engine, and recently there was a new engine re-release that is running nicely on modern hardware, including the Steam Deck, and now the game is going to be rechecked and is probably going to be marked as verified. But I understand why it was like this. However, it did get me thinking about my own Steam library. What games in here are marked as unsupported that are very clearly not unsupported? Games that haven't been updated, games that never had an issue running on the Steam Deck, games that were working perfectly fine before the Steam Deck even came out. Maybe these games I'm cycling through on screen shouldn't be in the verified category. Some of them have annoying launches and would still fall into the playable category. Small text is also often a problem you'll see, especially for older games that are just made to be played on a big TV screen. But I can say for an absolute fact, none of these games should be marked as unsupported. And again, with 16,000 games across both playable and verified, mistakes are gonna happen, and it's kind of unreasonable to go back and test out random little games that, frankly, most people don't really care about. Like, how many people are actually gonna care if East Origin, Ty 3, Holocure are marked as unsupported on the Steam Deck? Holocure probably the most out of all of them, but even then, it's just not really that big of a deal. But I think there are some changes that could be made to drastically improve the system to make sure this doesn't keep happening in the future. Firstly, I would probably just eliminate the unsupported tag entirely and replace it with something like unoptimized, where it doesn't say the game isn't going to work on the Steam Deck whatsoever. It's just saying, okay, it might work on the Steam Deck, but your mileage may vary. You might need to make some tweaks, you might need to do something, and then it might work, but it's not explicitly saying this is definitely not going to work, which is the impression that people seem to get from the unsupported tag, and I understand it because that's what it says on the Steam Deck compatibility. Unsupported is supposed to mean it won't work on the Steam Deck. Along with this, or doing this, I would also go and change the way the unsupported is added and make sure it's only being put on games that basically are guaranteed to not work. Things like very heavy anti-cheat where the developers just haven't enabled it. VR, because the Steam Deck is not a VR device, so obviously it is unsupported. Also requiring some sort of like unique input control that doesn't match what the Steam Deck has. But this only partially addresses the problem. It doesn't fix the issue of the ratings just being misapplied. A game that is verified that is not supposed to be verified. A game that is playable that's not supposed to be playable. If unoptimized or unsupported is there, a game still having that rating and not supposed to be in that category any longer. The thing is, Valve already has all of the pieces in place to fix this issue, and they've already implemented part of the way there, but they've just haven't connected everything together. Firstly, when you play a game on the Steam Deck and you quit out of the game, it'll say, hey, does verified, playable, unsupported match your experience with the game? You can say yes, no, and I believe there's a maybe option as well. Okay, this is one thing. This is a way to give a bit of feedback about the current state of the game. Secondly, there's been a recent addition to the Steam reviews. Now, if you played on a Steam Deck, it'll say, this game was primarily played on a Steam Deck. And this person noticed that this is a game that is marked as unsupported, but runs perfectly fine on the Steam Deck. Thirdly, Valve already has a system for aggregating user feedback and aggregating feedback based on when it was given in the form of their review system. So you might already see where I'm going here. What I would like to see from Valve is keep your internal testing system. Keep the criteria for what a verified, playable, and unsupported game is. Whilst I don't like this system, I really doubt unsupported is going to go away, but I do like the criteria for what makes a game actually verified. This is perfectly fine. Keep the system, keep doing your testing. But alongside having your internal testing, also do something like we see from ProtonDB and make it this, even better, a collaborative effort with ProtonDB where you can build off their already existing large data set and then have a way for the community to give direct feedback about the current state of a game. So if a game is marked as verified and players who have a Steam Deck on their account who played the game on a Steam Deck, because I know you already have that information because you can show it in the reviews, if those people say the game is not actually verified, it has this issue, that issue, you can then use that as a guidepost to then possibly lower it down. If players play an unsupported game and that game works perfectly fine, not with Proton GE, but with a mainline version of Proton, use that as a guidepost to indicate maybe this is something we need to retest and have that shown directly next to the game. Like it's already being shown with your review status where people can say a game is really good and it shows very positive there. If it could show unsupported and then right under that, user feedback verified, user feedback playable, or maybe use some other different rating system like very playable, something like that, so it doesn't like step over your current system, but have a way to keep your testing in check using the people who obviously want to play the games, who obviously are already willing to write reviews and do other things like this. Make use of that large community that is there to sort of outsource some of that work. But here's the thing, this is probably not going to happen. So because that's the case, I don't think you should pay any attention to what Valve says the compatibility rating of a game actually is. They can do the testing all they want, but if the testing is going to just not make any sense and is not going to be informed by the community, I would say just ignore what they have and just look at ProtonDB, because here you're going to find out the state the games are actually in. Let's say, I don't know, what is Age of Empires 3 Definitive Edition. This will also break it down by the different system you want to play on. So we have PC reviews, we have Steam Deck reviews, we have... Okay, there's no one that's done Chrome OS. No one cares about Chrome OS, but yeah, Chrome OS reviews are also supported on ProtonDB as well. But you can then break this down, and if there are problems, you can then see what was done with a game that potentially ends up fixing it. This is what I do every single time. I don't pay any attention to what it says on the Steam Deck. Let's say I wanted to play Black Myth Wukong, for example, which I wouldn't recommend playing on a Steam Deck because it looks really, really good, and you cannot really configure it to run well on the Steam Deck. But assuming it's a game that is going to run well, or just generally on Linux desktop, this is where I go to. This is always a good resource. But what do you think? Do you think the Steam Deck compatibility rating is totally fine? Do you ever look at it? Do you just go to ProtonDB? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, silly Verify link in the description down below. And if you have a Steam Deck, let me know what you've been playing on it. The last thing I played on this was East 1 and 2, so I'll probably play through most of the rest of the series on this thing anyway.